In this example, we've got a slightly different situation. So we still have these gaps here, which we clearly need to fill in. But now, there's some useful information, and it's no longer stored over here, but it seems to be in the same column over here. So we need to somehow get Excel to know that this London applies to all of those, New York applies to all of those, etc. So we can do that by making use of an if function. So how do we do this? The first thing is to see what can we tell Excel to look out for to know that this is the word we're looking for. If we tell it to look in this column and see if there's a word there, it'll get confused with all of these. So what we need to do is look and see is what is unique about this row that we can use. And you'll notice that London, New York, Paris, and Johannesburg, all of them seem to have blanks over here. So that's the first thing we're going to do. We're going to do a test, and we're going to say, is it a blank over here? So over here, I'm going to go and put my function is, and there's a function in Excel called isBlank. And all I'm going to tell Excel is go, look where the numbers are, and tell me if it's a blank. And you'll see it gives us a true or a false, and we could copy it down, and we get our various trues or falses. But now what we need to do is tell Excel that if it sees a blank there, it must look at that name. If there isn't a blank, so if we were down here somewhere, it can't look at this name, but what it can do is just look one above it, because it will probably be looking at London. So let's build it. So I'm going to put the if around it. And we're going to say if the blank equals true, then what must it do? It must look in that cell there. If it's not true, I'm going to tell it just to look one up. I'm going to close it and click enter. And what you'll see is when I copy it down, it is clever enough to know. So for example, over here, it looks here, doesn't see a blank, looks one up. That one did the same thing, which therefore looks at this one, which is correct. When it gets to New York, there's a blank here, does the same thing. Once you've done this, however, you must be careful, because these are formulas, you don't want to now start manipulating and affecting the formulas. So generally speaking, what we do is we highlight this, we'd copy it, and we'd paste it as values. And once we've done that, we can then fill in these gaps using the tools we already know. So I'm going to go here, we'll use the GOTO Special, blanks, it's looking over here, I'm going to say equals the one above. So that looks fine. Remember, highlight it, paste as values. And then, just to get rid of all the unnecessary information, I go to data, put my filter on, and I now know that there's certain items I'm going to remove. So what we need to do is now figure out which items we're going to remove here. So I know that I have no interest in seeing London, New York here, because I have got it all on the side. So I would go here, switch on the towns, highlight them, delete the row, and when I clear it, I've now got the cities on the left-hand side, and they're all correctly aligned to the data.